as we have just started the chapter, the sound of music, right? Chapter 2 from your Bihai textbook. In it, we have started the first part, part 1. It is about Evelyn Glennie, one of the Scottish girl who learned a music without hearing it. So, in this second part of this chapter, we will see one of the girl who achieved her goal, still he has one of the unpotentiality and then she make a potentiality herself. So, here in the last video, we started its explanation. Till the third paragraph we have completed. She was 8 years old and she also discouraged by her teachers. Then after her teachers and everyone suggested her mother. What was the name of her mother? Isabel Glennie. And all of them suggested her to take her to the one of the specialists. So she took Evelyn to the specialist and she was using what hearing aids. And by using it, but she was unsuccessful in it and she just felt that decreased by all of the people around her. And after that, what happened? She did not give up. And then after, she started her journey towards in her life. Then after, what happened? She just taught and got one of the famous and great teacher. His name was Ron Fox. Ron Fox. Ron Fox teaches her, you can say Ron Fox. Ron Fox spotted her, encouraged her, he has given her inspiration, motivation, and he knows her potentiality. And finally, he started to teach her music. How? Different way. He said, don't try to listen from your ear, you try to listen from your feelings. It means from your body parts. You have to use other way to listen the music and then after you learn it. So finally, by saying to Ron Fox, Evelyn learned the music. So Ron Fox started to drum, to play the drum, and he first of all make two different notes. Right? First, he said, try to listen from your other ways, it means from your body part. So he made two different notes and said, try to listen it different way. So what happened here? Evelyn started to learn that music other way, by feelings, by sensitivity, and then after, she just used her body parts. What happened? When Ron Fox started to play the first upper part of the notes of music, Evelyn Glennie used the upper part of her waist. So from this portion of her body, she learned the upper drum or upper notes of the drum. And from the waist, it means what happened? Lower part of the waist, it means lower part of the body, she learned the second, it means lower notes of the music. So till here, it means we have seen vibration and the sounds she learned by her body parts. We'll see the fourth part now. She never looked back. From that point onwards, she taught the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra, and by the time she was 16 and she had decided to make music her life. When she was just, we have seen from 8 years she started her deafness. When she was just 8 years old, she just noticed and hide her deafness from the friends and her teachers. When she was just 11 years old, finally she was completely deaf. And when she was, it means after that she did not give up, but she started her learning. And when she was just 16 years old, what she had done? She never looked back from the point onwards and she taught. Taught means what? Travel. She traveled to United Kingdom to learn the music with the youth orchestra. Orchestra means what? A group. Group of the people who are just going to learn the music, right? So she just met with the youth, right? Young people who was going, just that those people who are going to learn the music. So she joined them. And when she went to United Kingdom, kingdom. By the time she was 16, when she was just 16 years old, she went to the UK with the youth orchestra, with the group. And then after, she had decided to make music her life. Finally, she just decided, I have to achieve my goal. So she was working hard towards her goal. And she auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of academy. But this audition gave a short performance so that the director could decide whether she was good enough. ऑडिशन राइट कोई भी ऑडिशन होता है उसमें हमें शॉर्ट परफॉर्मेंस देना पड़ता है राइट वी हैव टू गिव अ शॉर्ट परफॉर्मेंस इन दैट फ्रॉम दैट परफॉर्मेंस द जज जज वी कैन से राइट द डायरेक्टर विल जज अस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एंड देन आफ्टर दैट विल डिसाइड हर फ्यूचर सो सी गिव दैट ऑडिशन इन दैट ऑर्केस्ट्रा ग्रुप एंड द रॉयल एकेडमी ऑफ म्यूजिक राइट दिस इज द नेम ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर इंस्टीट्यूट एंड स्कॉर्ड वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट मार्क्स इन द achieved the highest marks in the music, but Evelyn Plenney has achieved because she got the highest marks. She was only to get the highest marks in the history of academy, in the Royal Academy of Music. She gradually moved from the orchestral work to the solo performance. I said orchestral means what? Crew, right? So finally, when she got the highest marks in that particular academy, what happened? Gradually, slowly moved from the orchestral work to first. Initially, she was working in group, but then after she worked solo. Solo means what? Single, alone, right? So, first initially she was working in group, but then after she was just giving her solo performance. It means now she started to learn music to got her all the achievements. Single, only, alone, only. At the end of her 3 years course, she had captured most of the top awards. So she completed her 3 years course, and then after, in these 3 years, she got all the top awards, and she became very famous in this world. So in this paragraph, it is about her top awards. Now see next. And for all, this Evelyn will not accept any hint of heroic achievement. So when she got all the top awards in her life, all the people knows her and she become the famous thing around the world. So what happened, what she said here, Evelyn will not accept. If someone will say her, you are very great, she said, no, it's my achievement only. If you work hard and know where you are going, get there. So here, Evelyn Plenney was talking two main important things for the success. First of all, it is hard work. And second one is aim. So Evelyn Plenney said that these two things will give you success. So here what she said, if you work hard, if you will do work hard and know where you are going and you decided your aim, then no one will stop you to achieve your goal. Definitely you will get your aim, you will get your goal. So here what he said, if you work hard and know where you are going, know where you are going, it means your aim, and work hard, right? If you will do work hard and you decided your goal, your aim, you definitely you will get there, right? And see what high right to the top, the world's most sought after multi-percussionist with a mastery of some 1,000 instruments and the hectic international schedule. Now, what happened here? What she said? So finally, she decided to do work hard first of all, and then make your aim. Definitely, you will achieve your goal. So she did that also. Then she got her life to the top awards, and then finally, she got every achievement in her life with a mastery. She learned the 1,000 of musical instruments, and she became also the percussionist. The percussionist means what? Musician, best great musician with the mastery of. And she got the mastery on all the instruments of the music and hectic international schedule. Finally, see, just it means here, in any instant performance or functions, the people were calling her to give her performance. hearing in eye to eye discussion, see, never missed a word. Just as he said, what man with this fear brings, give me trouble and still love. Now, here, who is the writer of this lesson? Deborah Cowley. What he said, it is intriguing. Intriguing means what? Fascinating or very curious about something. It is intriguing to watch evident functions so effortlessly without hearing it. See, become the topmost musician in the world, you can say. See, got that, see, become a topper of music, right? So what happened here? With effortlessly means with the effort, by your willingness, we can say, see, just when he said something to us, in our two-hour discussion, who audience who here? Deborah Cowley and Evelyn Glennie. She took her interview. Who? Deborah Cowley took her interview and she said in that interview, what? See, men with her disappears, give me trouble. You can say that by her body parts, she learned the music. So what has she said here? Who? Those people always make her trouble. Who missing beards, right? A people who has a long hair means a beard, right? So that man gives me more trouble. Why she said these things? Because she said she can't able to see the proper lips expression, because here so many hairs are there, busy words there. That's why what she said, the man who has a busy, we can say, right? They always give me trouble. Why? Because I did not able to identify what they were saying to me. In front of me, who is sitting there and that person was disappears, they always gives me trouble. Because by the expression of her their lips, I can identify what they want to say me. Right? So always she says, see, just make a laugh here and give some friends to the people. It is, not just watching the lips, it's the whole face, especially the eyes. She speaks flawlessly with this Scottish lip. Now see, Deborah Cowley was taking her interview. So what he, whenever he just asked any question, every answer she gave. And then after what happened, she said, a busy man always gives me trouble because I was not able to identify what they wanted to see me. So she just laughed and said, not only just watching their lips, she was not showing her their lips only, but the whole face. By the expression of the face, she was able to learn that what they wanted to say her, especially the eyes. And from the eyes also, you know that when she was just learning, right, the music from the Ron Props said her, try to learn from the other way. It means use your body part. So first of all, she just we can say looked towards the lips of the people. Then after she said whole face, and then she said, I can identify what the people want me to say me by the eyes also. So she speaks flawlessly with the Scottish lip. What is Scottish? I said she belongs to Scotland. And lilt means what? Scottish lilt means a way of speaking. We can say the language accent. Accent, right? We can say accent means what? The language from particular place they are belonging. Right? She speaks flawlessly with the Scottish lilt. Because she belongs to Scotland, she knows very well how to speak the Scottish language. My speech is clear because I could hear till I was 11. Why she had that mastery on that particular language? Because she belonged to Scotland, and when she was just 11 years old, he knows the language, she said. But that does not explain how she managed to learn French and the master basic Japanese. But then she said, I do not know these two languages, because French and Japanese, because she belonged to the Scotland. And then after she learned the French language also and Japanese also. So she said that, but that does not explain how she managed to learn. See, eagerly wanted to learn these two languages, but she finally learned it, right? But that much this girl Evelyn Glennie just started her journey and she became the highest top voice of the musical world. As for music, she explained, it goes into every part of my body. Finally, she said, what happened? This music sprayed in my whole body. It means I just feel music everywhere. A single hint gave me the musical identification. We'll stop it here.